Morning students, today Thursday, our moral science turn is here. We are going to continue our second chapter, No Excuses. Here the chapter is that we not have to say excuse of anything. We have to make ourselves self-dependent. So we'll continue the chapter from page number 11. Ways to develop self-discipline. What are the ways by which we make ourselves self-disciplined? First, overcome laziness and postponing things that must be done, such as homework assignment or cleaning your cupboard. We have just to make ourselves self-disciplined. We just avoid to be laziness. Have to do all the work which have to do so without any delaying. Have to complete our homework on time, complete the assignment on time, and to make our books and other necessary things which are just related to me, have to keep at proper place, and time to time just check our room to make it clean, and as well as the cupboard. Second, continue doing your work with commitment even if it is not interesting. Never think that the work which you like most, only do those things. Even the things which you have a little less interest, then also make a commitment that I have to do this work at any cost. Try to do, surely you will get the success. You can do. So make yourself confident to complete the work which is of a little less interest. Study or practice a sport or any form of art life while your mind tells you to play video games and watch televisions. Have to make our mindset. Instead, our mind is telling to watch a television, to play a mobile game on the mobile. So have to just divert our mind from there and make ourselves confident in doing the work which is more necessary. So once we make our mindset to do the thing, we can surely do it. Otherwise, our mind always tells just the things which I like most to do those things. Keep things in their proper place. The things which are lie here and there in the room, try to keep it at their proper place, then only you become a self-disciplined person. Go to bed on time and wake up early on your own. Don't be dependent on anyone elder at home that you are going to tell your mama or your father just to wake up you in the morning. Try to go early on the bed and wake up in the morning early. Do something productive instead of wasting time. Don't think that these days the schools are off, so the teachers are uploading the videos. I can watch anytime, the whole 24 hours are with me. I have not to go anywhere. Instead of wasting the time, just in the morning, according to the time that is given to you, just check the videos, learn the subjects, and after that, try to engage yourself in something which is a meaningful work, means which gives something, a lesson to you. Instead of wasting a time, that lot of time is there, I can spend here, I can sit there, I can chat to my friend, I can talk to my friend, I can play outside the home. Instead of wasting the time, engage your mind in some productive work, to do something instead of making your mind in any destructive work. Get ready to go to school and complete other chores without being reminded. Just be ready for the school on time and don't wait for anyone that who will be there behind you to remind you that you have to do such and such things. Become self-dependent. Balance work and play. In between the work and your play, just make a balance. How much time I have to spend in playing and how much I have to work in studies and other work. So have to make a balance in between them. These are some of the points by which we make ourselves self-disciplined. Self-discipline will help you from good habits, break bad ones, and improve self-control. But it requires practice continuously. It doesn't mean that one day or 2 days I did some work. Now that is enough. If you want to become a self-discipline, you have to be in practice in a regular routine. From getting up early in the morning till the night when you go to bed for sleep. So make your habit, set a timetable, divide the day, which work have to do at what time, what the time is suitable for any work. So set according to that, otherwise you will never be able to complete your task of a day. Here some examples are given from the real life. As you students watch the television, you can see many of the musicians are there, the famous actor actresses are there, then the famous leaders are there, sports person are there. How you can be able to see on a television. Their names are on the newspaper, in the magazines. How it could be possible? You will not find everyone's name in the television, in the newspaper, in the magazines. Why only the selected peoples are shown on the television, in the newspapers, about them, the article is there? Because of what? As they are the self-disciplined people, they are spending lot of time on themselves to achieve their goal, to make a successful person. So here are some of the examples of the real life is given to you. We see famous actors, musicians and sports persons on television. We admire their achievements and applaud them. We think on them that how they become a successful person. Everyone knows their name. Either a political leader or a famous actor is there, any sports personality, any musician or a singer is there, or a dancer. But we do not consider the hours of hard work they have to put in and the self-discipline they have practiced. We don't know how much pain they are taking to make themselves up to that goal. We only come to know about their achievements, what behind them, how much they are just practicing about to become that famous personality. Because of their only to just set their goal and have to work on it on regular basis. Some of the young sports person who participated in the Rio Olympics are models of self-discipline. Here some of the examples are given. They disciplined themselves to follow rigorous routine early in their life and focused on their goals. Just there, they set themselves about what have to do. The rigorous routine means done very carefully. What the aim, what the aim they have decided, they are just focused on it and do the work very carefully to achieve their goal. So here, while most of the people slept, shuttler PV Sindhu started her practice at 4:30 a.m. in the morning. When most of the people are sleeping, she started practicing at 4:30 a.m. in the morning. She worked hard for 15 hours a day. Out of the 24 hours, she worked or she gives on her practice about total 15 hours. She treated herself to an ice cream only after she won a silver medal. Treated herself an ice cream means just before it melts, we try to finish the ice cream. So here the aim of the show, so the PV Sindhu focused on her goal before she become out of the range or unable to get the success. She just focused to and practice day and night and then become a successful sportsperson and won the silver medal. Sakshi Malik also followed a strict diet and trained hard. She became India's first woman wrestler to win the Olympic bronze medal. Sakshi Malik is also a wrestler who won the bronze medal in Olympic. Deepa Karmakar practiced for 3 hours in morning and 3 hours in the evening. Ever since she started her training, she was a gymnast right. She was the first Indian female gymnast to represent India at the 216 Summer Olympics. She was the first to participate in the Summer Olympics in 2016. While youngsters enjoy treats, delicious food and playing with gadgets, these athletes choose to say no. When we people are just thinking to enjoy a delicious food, a tasty food, and just to enjoy, to make ourselves entertained by watching movies on the television, in the theater, playing games on the mobile phones, etc., attending the parties, enjoying just in the park and having fun. So these people say no to all these things and they only focus to achieve their goal. Then only they become a successful person and we come to know or we hear their names in the television, in the newspapers, magazines, books, everywhere. That did not contribute to their goal. So be disciplined to achieve all that you want. We have to become a self-discipline to achieve our goal. Here on page 13, learn from nature. What is given here? Look at the ants closely. There is a queue of an ant. Their self-discipline is amazing. If you have ever watched that when ants are moving, they do not just in a hurry just to overtake the another ant. They just move slowly, slowly, one after another. They are following the ant who is moving in front of her instead of just to overtake her. So they follow the discipline. No one is there to instruct them, to teach them how to follow. It is the God-gifted nature. So we have to learn from them. Ants do not have to guide to instruct them. They work on their own without anyone telling them that what work to do and when to do it. They decide and start doing it. They do not postpone what must be done for the day, so they are prepared ahead. They do not think it is a morning, it is afternoon, I will just do it later in the evening, even in the night also. If you find somewhere, you can see they are slowly moving and up to a long height or a long distance they cover to find their food or to achieve their goal. So we have to learn from them, and to make ourselves self-disciplined, we have to first set our goal, set our aim, what to become in future. And according to that, we have to set our timetable, what to do, when to wake up, what should be the schedule, and what have to, and then have to follow it. So you also aim for your future goal and start doing accordingly. Still the time is there. Have a good day.